Hey everyone, I'm Pratik, and in this video we're going to be looking at a clinical governance scenario which hopefully should help you practice for your dental foundation and dental core training interviews. If you want to see more educational videos like this, please make sure to subscribe to the channel. The scenario that we're looking at in this video is the following. A patient attends complaining of pain from an upper right tooth. On reading his records, you note that he has a carious upper right 7 which was due for treatment by your colleague. For some reason, the treatment was not completed and the patient was not provided any future appointments. Discuss how you would manage this case. So in this video, we're treating this as a clinical governance scenario. However, it could also be treated as a clinical communication or a normal clinical scenario for dental core training. So you can practice it in any of the following forms. As I've previously discussed, I like to divide these scenarios into three parts. First, we want to look at the standards that are affected. We then want to look at the short-term management, and we then want to follow this by looking at the long-term management. So broadly speaking, we're dealing here with a patient who has had incomplete treatment. The GDC standards that are affected. In virtually every situation, the first standard, working in the patient's best interest and safety, is affected. Because the patient has had potentially incomplete treatment here, we need to make sure we're making the right decisions for the patient. The patient is also in pain, so we need to make sure we're getting them out of pain. We then also need to make sure we communicate effectively with the patient. We need to make sure they understand what's happening, and hopefully we bridge any gaps from the previous treatment that was carried out to diffuse any potential unpleasant situations. It is a sensitive topic with this patient, and so we need to make sure that we mitigate any potential issues that may arise. This leads on to the next standard that we have to consider, which is complaints, having a clear and effective complaints procedure. This patient, because they have had incomplete treatment, may want to subsequently complain. So we need to be aware of this. We also have to consider standard 8, which is raising concerns. We've got a colleague who may not be carrying out appropriate treatment, and so this is another red flag that we need to consider when we're answering this scenario. Is there something else that needs to be investigated? And we'll deal with this later on in the scenario. Other general things that we need to discuss: potential claims of clinical negligence, so this is something you may want to talk about, clinical competency of your colleague, and also, just to tie it in, you may want to mention clinical governance and factors such as auditing and record keeping. Let's look at the short-term management. So the first aspect is that we need to explain the patient's dental situation to them. We need to make sure they understand why they're in pain and how we're going to try and manage this. This is the priority if we think about the first standard. Following this, we then need to listen to the patient's concerns. So they may be unhappy that treatment wasn't completed, that they were missed in terms of their diary and they weren't given another appointment. We need to listen to these concerns and try to reassure them or apologize if necessary. We then need to get the patient out of pain. This is the priority, whether they want to complain or not, whether they want to discuss anything else or not. Our priority is to get the patient out of pain. So this may be giving pain relief, it may be accessing and dressing a tooth, it may be taking the tooth out, whatever we can decide on mutually with the patient, that's what we want to carry out. We then also want to make sure that the patient is provided adequate long-term care. So stating to them that you're going to follow it up, you're going to make sure they're booked in then and there for any further treatment that may be necessary. This helps show that you're trying to avoid the same mistake happening again. If you feel you can't carry out the treatment, then you may want to refer them to a colleague. So again, this is something that you'd mention to the patient. The patient may state they want to complain, and so we'd want to talk to them about the complaints procedure, and the practice or the hospital will have a clear and effective complaints procedure in place. So the patient needs to be referred to this. Following on from this, we then have three standard things that you'd want to consider in any scenario. The first one, you would want to speak to your supervisor. So discuss the case with the supervisor, make sure that you are happy with what you've done and they're happy with what you've done. It may be that you actually want to get them in when the patient is there, or it may be something that you're relatively comfortable with handling, but you want to get them in later on or have a chat with them later on. Following this, you also want to speak to your indemnity provider. Although you may have done everything within your power, you want to make sure you're covered in all ways. So you may want to give your indemnity provider a call and see what they think about the situation. And you then want to keep clear, concise and contemporaneous notes. Document everything that's been done in this appointment. Make sure you've documented all your actions and the patient's responses to this as well, so that if anything does come from this scenario, you've got everything documented clearly. This looks at the short-term management. Let's now look at the longer-term management for this patient. Carrying on from what I mentioned earlier, we want to ensure the patient gets the appropriate care. So we need to make sure they're followed up properly. We need to make sure that their pain has been settled, and any other follow-up telephone calls, reviews, anything that needs to be done is in the diary so that the patient doesn't go through any further problems. Additionally, if they have put a complaint in, we need to make sure that this is followed up according to the practice's complaints policy, because we don't want to miss this off. We also want to discuss this case with the colleague. It'd be worth, if you're not comfortable with it, your supervisor doing it, or you're doing it collectively, to understand Was this a one-off incident, in which case we just need to be aware of what happened? Or is it a recurring pattern that needs further investigating? Team meetings may be necessary if it's a one-off, because we may want to look at how we can avoid this happening again. So do we need to have more robust booking in systems? Do we need to ensure that follow-ups are checked? Anything like that. So getting the entire team involved. We may also want to audit and look at missed appointments to ensure that we don't have any of these happening elsewhere, because there may be other patients that have had the same situation but just haven't experienced any pain yet. If you find that this is a recurring pattern, you may then want to raise concerns and escalate as necessary. So as a dental core trainee or foundation dentist, you may feel out of your depth doing this, so your supervisor may be more responsible for this. But it would be a case of looking at things like negligence and escalating as necessary. So ideally within your practice manager may want to speak to the colleague to make sure that this doesn't happen again, or gradually it would get escalated, but ultimately ending up at a GDC fitness to practice hearing. We may also want to just do general CPD. So we may all want to learn from the situation. If it's treatment related, we may want to do some further CPD regarding the treatment, or your colleague may want to do this if they weren't happy doing the treatment that was put in front of them. And finally, you want to reflect on the situation and document this in your portfolio. This would be reflecting on the appointment, but also the follow-up, how your colleague was handled, how you communicated with your supervisor, and what you can learn from this. So there we've looked at the standards, we've looked at the short-term management, and we've looked at the long-term management of this situation in order to try and maximize what we can get from answering this type of station. I hope you found that useful. My recommendation in this video is another YouTuber, Yewande. Now she has done a huge number of videos on progressing through dental school, some of the challenges along the way, and now she's currently doing a foundation dentistry and is documenting this. I strongly suggest you check out her channel for a bit more information. So I hope you found this video useful. If you did, make sure you like, comment and subscribe, and let me know of any other videos that you'd like me to do. Until the next video, take care.